Okay, the local school districts that we serve here, which happen to be Wray, Yuma, Otis, their bandwidth needs in particular have really climbed the last few years, and some of that is due to the computer student ratio that they have finally stepped up to. Some of the school districts have had a difficult time figuring out exactly how they wanted to approach the technology side of things and how they justify and the expense, all that jazz. But more importantly, it wasn't that long ago a T1, which is 1.5 megabits per second, was just boatloads of bandwidth for them, and nobody could ever foresee them outgrowing them. And yet today, I believe in Wray, we're serving them with 4 megabits, which we have to do over the wireless game because there's no other way to do it. And I believe in Yuma, they're taking in 3 megabits, and Otis, we just upgraded them to 3 megabits. They're a much smaller school district and didn't have the student population. But my point there is that their needs are only going to continue to grow. Especially because they want to get into the distance learning thing, to where, you know, the students in the classrooms here can tap into a school or a class that's being offered, say, in Fort Morgan or Boulder or Fort Collins or Colorado Springs or some other school, you know, in the state, to where they can, you know, tap in and do this collaborative thing and have one teacher, one instructor deal with not just a handful of students like they do out here, versus, you know, making it cost effective and offering it to, you know, 30, 40, 50 students, conceivably even more. But it's going to take bandwidth to do that. And that's the key. You know, the bigger the pipe, it's what it's going to be required.
And how about the medical services in the area? Are you involved with any of them?
We currently are not. There is a consortium that started several years ago to where they do telemedicine with, but they typically do that on an emergency basis only, where if they've got something very unusual, for example, a gunshot wound, is pretty uncommon out here. And when they do have those types of things, they use that telemedicine link, they'll fire that up, and then they'll talk to a specialist in, say, Greeley or Fort Collins, in order so that the doctors here can prepare that patient properly before they transport them up there. Make sure that they, you know, give them the best possible care that they can. They're currently not doing the telemedicine to where you can have a specialist sit in Greeley or Fort Collins or Denver and deal with a patient in a clinical type setting. Typically it's on an emergency only basis. Today that may change, I don't know.
However, bandwidth would...
Again, bandwidth is going to be the key, and they're currently paying big bucks for what they're doing today. And you know, the fiber optic connectivity is going to be the key, because that, again, is only going to expand. For example, they're only doing that on the old style television resolution rates. To do high def, it's going to take more bandwidth. And you all know where high definition's gone. They're going to want it too in the telemedicine thing. I also know that, you know, law enforcement, emergency services, again, their requirements for bandwidth are continuing to climb. And that's mostly... Well, due to several different areas. One is the interdepartmental cooperation, coordination. You know, they have they call it WY Communications here. It's the local 911 center, serves 2 counties, and they coordinate with the Washington County Sheriff's Office, the Yuma County Sheriff's Office, and then the Yuma PD and the Wray PD. Akron and Otis do not have their own independent PDs. The Sheriff's Office serves all their law enforcement needs. And so they coordinate between all those things, and we know that as things progress, they're going to want to do more and more kinds of things, and they're going to need greater expanded telecommunications capacity. For example, Wray just recently deployed a TV, or I should say a camera-based monitoring system for certain intersections, certain streets. They put some cameras in the school so that they can, you know, for safety purposes, the PD wants to be able to monitor these things, potentially record events, et cetera, et cetera. We know they haven't asked for that capacity today. For all I know, they've asked for it, but they haven't included us in the conversation. But, you know, the 911 center, the logical step is to connect them into that network. It's only a matter of time before Yuma wants to do the same thing. I mean, we can see these things coming because there's trends, there's patterns that evolve with the technology development. And we know that that's eventually going to happen.